But take a look at how this changes our diagram. In the old version, we had only one function object because it had been defined outside of the car-like function. Now, as a result of the fact that we moved the source code for that move method up into the body of the car-like function, we now have a new function being generated every time we run the car-like function. This is a high price to pay for the simplicity of having all of your code show up at the same level of indentation inside the body of the car-like function. People are often confused why it would be the case that moving the function definition up into the body of this function would result in there being many move methods, many different function objects, one per instance of a car. Let's open a new file to examine that point. This simple maker function builds and returns a brand new object. So after calling make an object twice and storing each of the results in a variable, do you expect the two objects that are stored in these two variables to be the exact same, or to be two objects that look quite similar because of the similarities in their properties? Another way of asking this is, would they pass a strict comparison of their identity using triple equals?